to organise an interview with the Right Honourable Michael Izan. Your Excellency, how do you see the European debt crisis from a Canadian perspective?
First of all, as I'm here in Greece, and of course, we're very concerned about what Greece is experiencing and has been experiencing in the last 6 years with that crisis of great magnitude, when we think that you saw like a decline of your GDP of 27%, 25%, that you've lost your economic, I would say, capacity of 40%. The magnitude also of unemployment hitting the youth of Greece to a level of 60%. It's major. It's major. But I would say that it's not a Greek crisis. It's a crisis that is hitting the world as a whole. Then it's about reflecting upon what the solutions can be. And I think that we can find the answers here. It's about rebuilding our capacities and coming together stronger than ever in a new spirit of unity, of solidarity. It's about making sure that the European community can also validate the efforts being made here in Greece. And I'm sure that it's really important for the Greek people to understand that whatever will be achieved here to overcome that ordeal, to overcome that challenge, will be important not just for Greece alone, but for the world. So I think that as you are actually trying to bring together everything that you have, everything that you want to change in that huge metamorphosis that is so important, it will be a reference, it will be an example for the world to say, this is what Greece has achieved, this is what Greece has done to really emerge and come out of this crisis. I am not discouraged. I think apathy, morosity, cynicism is not the way to go. We need to see this challenge as an opportunity at a greater scale, but also in reigniting synergies in small businesses, in new ideas, in creativity, in innovation, making sure that all these young people who right now have the feeling of a dead end can also feel included as, you know, part of the solutions. I think this is the energy that needs to triumph in this country. Nothing is small. Every gesture, every initiative, every sense of entrepreneurship will make the difference in Greece. So as much as Greece is right now thinking of big reforms in its public administration, in the way of delivering services to the population, of restoring its economy, it's really important to understand that also, you know, what is happening at the grassroots level is important. This is, I mean, at the basis of my message as I come here to Greece.
Thank you very much for your answer. You have an impressive record in promoting multiculturalism And I'm wondering, how could countries better achieve multiculturalism, such as Greece, for example?
You see, Greece is a land of a great civilization that became stronger and stronger and delivered so much to the world because of its capacity of integrating many cultures and other civilizations. Greece has provided so many amazing ideas. The strength of philosophy, that is the science of meaning, and I find that Greece has built something for humanity that comes also from its capacity to embrace and to be open, you know, to many cultures. I think that what is important with the building tensions that we can feel, as there are a lot of frustrations because of the economic crisis, tensions around immigration, for example, right now, what will certainly help in bringing about change and solutions to those tensions is to remember that at one time, Greeks also experienced the same. Many Greeks had to leave Greece to find a new life and a better future elsewhere. I know, for example, that as my family, like thousands of other families from Haiti, experienced, you know, exile and a huge exodus and arrived in Canada as a shelter land, as a to find a new life, Greeks also went through that same experience in the 70s and before. And I lived myself in the Greek neighborhoods of Montreal, in Canada, in Quebec. And I think that the Greeks who arrived in Canada became part of building that society, building that country. They became like an important force in Canada. So as now in Greece, you are experiencing the arrival of people who are looking for a shelter, a place where they can find a new life. You need to remember that you were there at one time. It could be you, you know. So when we look at the other, this is what we have to be able to project in that person, that young Afghan on the street, that young Syrian, that Syrian man or Syrian woman looking for a shelter, for a new life, coming from Africa and other parts, could be you. Every time you have to say, it could be me, it could be my brother, it could be my sister, it could be my father, it could be my mother. So if we don't connect this way, you know, then what happens is a total indifference to the other. But if we can connect at a human level, then we realize that that person can become, you know, I would say, an added value to what we are trying to achieve. That sense of hospitality that has always been, you know, a quality in the Greek culture has to be there always, today like yesterday. And we need to be to identify to that person's experience right now. So this is what we do every day in Canada. I'm not saying that we don't have issues, that we don't have problems in accepting the other in Canada. Canada contains a world. Canada is this kind of a nation. But every time we see that there are difficulties, we understand that the responsibility is a shared responsibility. It's not just the government, it's everyone who can, and all, you know, the different experiences that can come together in order to build a solution to the new new challenges that we see. So you see, diversity, as we celebrate our diversity in Canada, this is all it is about. It's about, you know, uniting, coming together around our shared experiences and building something around this. And we see it as a value. We see it as a richness, not as a problem, but a richness.
Thank you very much. Your Excellency, would you like to introduce your foundation to the Greek audience, please?
You see, when I became Governor General and Commander-in-Chief of Canada, I had this huge privilege of crisscrossing this vast country that is Canada, engaging with Canadians from all walks of life, validating and recognizing the richness of our social fabric, of people's initiatives, of people's accomplishments, and promoting excellence in our country, promoting this idea of how much we can achieve when we work together, when we are together, how we can define our desire to live together as a strong country. And I had this huge privilege also of representing my country on more than 40 state visits around the world, and sharing the Canadian perspective. And my foundation, the Mikhail Jean Foundation, which is my legacy as former Governor General of Canada, is about continuing this work, but really focusing specifically on the youth, on the privileged youth, on the served youth, and their initiatives as very dynamic citizens, using the arts and culture as tools for social change. So I see how young people are using the power of the arts to tackle and address social issues, racism, exclusion, poverty, homelessness, discrimination, and how they are really using the arts as tools to bring about change in their communities and to revitalize their communities. It makes Canada a stronger country as they are doing that. And my foundation is about validating, supporting their initiatives and their actions so they can feel that they are part of Canada's growth, Canada's, I would say, richness as full citizens and active citizens in Canada. And as we are doing that, it's a way also of preventing a lot of social issues where when young people feel excluded, they become a prey for a lot of predators in our society. Criminal organizations who find it easier to enroll them when they are in a precarious situation. It's about making sure that young people can feel a part of society, can have a sense of belonging to their communities, and can have a sense that they are part of the solutions. Because I see the impact of their initiatives, how it contributes to making our communities stronger, more vibrant, healthier, and revitalizing. And the impact of their work has also also a positive effect on our economy. We support youth arts entrepreneurs, for example. It's really encouraging. So this is what my foundation is about. And I would say that one other endeavor that is very important to me is my work as Chancellor of the University of Ottawa. With Stavros Niarchos Foundation, we have created a scholarship program that is very important, that will enable young Greek students to come and study in Canada, not as a way of draining these brains from Greece, but reinforcing, a new generation that can contribute to what Greece wants to achieve to come out of this crisis right now, introducing new capacities, new professionals in Greece who have the possibility of studying on this, most important bilingual campus and university, and come back to Greece with, these new capacities. Also twinning, and building partnerships between Greek universities and the University of Ottawa. We also have a new program where we have decided to abolish substantially the fees that are imposed on foreign students in Canada, and so that they can access all our programs in our university, and it's a program built specially and offered to countries who are part of La Francophonie, and Greece is part of La Francophonie, to facilitate, the possibility of studying in a Canadian university like University of Ottawa, the University of Ottawa, and give them greater access to scholarships. So at one point, they can, even when they with these scholarships, they can even study for free at the University of Ottawa. Or, they are able to study at a very low fee. It's a huge, difference of close to 7,000 euros. It means instead of spending $10,000 to $12,000 a year, it comes down to $3,000 to $4,000 a year. And with the scholarship programs, it can come down even to no fees at all. It's quite exciting. So we are starting a new series of conferences where teachers from the University of Ottawa can come here and engage and support the Greek government and Greek universities in exploring, how do you manage change in a situation of crisis? How do you manage major reforms in your public administration? Which examples can be interesting? We want to share the Canadian experience with Greece. So I'm very happy to be here as a way of launching this new series. So Canada and Greece are together. What I want Greeks to understand is that you are not alone. We are there with you, and we believe in what you can achieve. We believe that we can make it, that Greece can and Greeks can.
Thank you very much for your optimism. Your Excellency, would you like to portray your role as UNESCO Special Envoy in Haiti?
It's really important because I feel that I'm very blessed. After serving my country of adoption, Canada, and as I continue to do so, I served as Governor General and Commander-in-Chief. I continue to play an active role in Canada through my foundation, that is national in scope. To be able now, as UNESCO Special Envoy for Haiti, I can bring my contribution to my native land. And to be able to do this in just one life is amazing. So the country of my birth, Haiti, was hit by a huge natural catastrophe in 2010 with that earthquake that devastated deeply the country. Now, as UNESCO Special Envoy, I can contribute to the efforts of reconstruction. And when it happened in Haiti, Haitians said, it's certainly an ordeal, but this ordeal has to be an opportunity. Rebuilding the country is not about going back to where we were. It's about a new foundation, founding the country again, strengthening our institutions, strengthening the rule of law, making education and investments in education a key to the reconstruction, building new infrastructures, changing the mentalities, emerging from total dependency to international aid, and building an economy, using everything that we have to offer. We don't have oil in Haiti, but we have a land of great beauty, and tourism can be a major leverage, you know, for the economy, because its impact is transversal. It goes to all sectors, agriculture, local products, education, new skills, new infrastructures, new services, engaging the communities, and making Haiti again an important destination. And Greeks understand that because we know in Greece that tourism is a major leverage for the economy. So in all the fields of action of UNESCO, which is the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, which we try to support governance capacities of Haiti in all these fields. We support initiatives of the civil society in these fields, and we work on the long term, not just, you know, in terms of crisis and emergency, but in really supporting the government's objectives in the long term and strengthening its capacity to achieve its national policies in these fields. So it's very exciting to see that that the will is there, so much is happening, and here is a country that is considered as one of the poorest in the Americas hemisphere, but where new partnerships, new cooperation, new collaborations are really making a difference, and where the government is investing everything it can, really in making, you know, Haiti hopefully in 30 years from now an emerging country. It's quite exciting, quite encouraging. And there's a special connection between Greece and Haiti, historically. Haiti was the first state in the world to recognize the Hellenic Republic, because it happened in January the 15th of 1822, and Haiti had proclaimed its republic in January 1st, 1804. And it's the first in the world. It was the first black republic in the world. So when Greece was fighting for its independence, to create a new republic, the Hellenic Republic, Haiti was there with Greece in its endeavor. And Haiti was the first state to recognize the Hellenic Republic. So it created a very special bond. And I remember how in Montreal, how Greeks and Haitians came together in Greek tavernas in Montreal, in these huge, you know, discussions and remembering this fact of history, what they stood together for, and in the time of the dictatorship here in Greece in the 70s, as Haitians were experiencing the same, how they would come together and exchange, you know, on the Haitian and the Greek experience and the resistance against, you know, oppression, against censorship, against dictatorship and the military dictatorship. So it's really amazing to see how much we have in common, how much we share. And I'm very touched to see the interest also of Stavros Niarchos Foundation to contribute to the reconstruction efforts in Haiti and to support my work also as UNESCO Special Envoy to Haiti. So you see, this is what solidarity is about. In difficult times, we can be together. In our greatest ideals, we can be together. Greece had given so much to the world, and what Greece will achieve in these difficult times will also be an important example to the world. It will be an important contribution to humanity today, as important as the contribution to the world through philosophy, through, you know, the institution of democracy, and coming together and achieving things together. So I'm confident. I'm very confident.
Your Excellency, thank you very much for this interview. It was an honor and pleasure to have you on the IMF Web TV.
Thank you very much.